Today I'm just going to show you a quick little intro tutorial to Inventor. So the first thing you're going to want to do is open up the program. Sometimes it can take a little bit long to load. There's a lot of information that is on the software. Yours will look a little different because you have Autodesk Inventor 2015 and I am running on 2014, but overall the functions are very similar. What will pop up right away is your welcome screen. You can go ahead and close out of this. And this will be our main home screen that will always show up the first thing that you do. So we are going to get started today by opening up a new file. When we're working on Inventor, we're always going to start with parts. These parts will be from a 2D sketch to then the 3D part that we can assemble within Inventor. Go ahead and select standard IPT. And once that loads, it'll pop up a screen that looks somewhat like this. Blank right now. We'll add to that. Very first thing you're going to want to do is go to the upper left hand corner, and that is create a 2D sketch. We're going to want to create our work plane, and I'm going to always select the XY. Once we're on here, it'll look like a grid. This is our origin point right here, 0, 0. You're always going to want to create your sketches starting at the origin. It just helps for easier measuring and easier to dimension. So today I'm going to just create a simple cube piece with a hole through it for you guys to see different functions of the program. Go ahead to the top here, our draw ribbon, and I'm going to select rectangle. You'll see my cursor now has a yellow dot that is following it, and also my XY coordinates. Another thing to note is that my dimensions are in inches right now. That is changeable. We'll go through that at a later date. Right now, don't worry about it. Just stay in inches. Once I move my cursor over to the origin, you'll see that it turns from yellow to green. That means I'm centered. You can also see my XY coordinates are at 0, 0. So go ahead and click once you're on the origin. And now, just like you were creating a shape in Word or Publisher, it'll drag out the sides of our square. I'm going to create a 1-inch by 1-inch square. So I can actually click on the number 1 on your keyboard, and that will enter in the top side of my square. Then I'm going to click on the tab button, and it will go to the other side of my square, and I'm going to click 1 again, and then all you have to do is click enter. Now you'll notice it's cut off a little bit. All you got to do is come down to your navigation cube. Yours might be in the upper right hand corner. Mine's down here. I'm going to click on the home button, and it'll recenter my drawing for me. Now you'll notice my cursor still has the XY coordinates on there. That's because it still thinks I'm in the draw function, which I am. So to get out of that, you need to press escape, and now your cursor should be back to normal. Okay, so our sketching of a square will automatically dimension and constrain itself, so it is set right now. You know a sketch is set in its dimensions if it is blue. If it is green or yellow, that means it's in progress. So once you have your sketch complete, we can click on the upper right hand corner, finish sketch. This will take us back to our part screen. Now I have my square, I want to make it a cube. What do I need to do? The first thing you got to do is click on your square using the right click. So right click on your square, and this will show a shortcut fast menu for many options that are commonly used on Inventor. I'm going to click extrude. This will make our image from 2D to 3D, and it'll automatically pop up a default extrusion length set at 1 inch. You can change the direction of your extrusions by going to this little icon where my mouse is that shows different directions. So you can go front, back, you can make it symmetric, or you can make it different lengths on both sides. I'm going to change it to direction 2. It's just a preference. It doesn't matter as long as you know what you're trying to do. And I'm going to leave it at 1 inch so it can be a 1 by 1 inch cube. Then I'm going to click OK. And I have my cube. Now, it might be difficult to see some of the shapes that you're working with. So if you want to change the viewing style of Inventor, you can go ahead and click on the View tab up in our top menu here. And under the Appearance ribbon, there is a Visual Style. You can go ahead and click on that, and it comes up with all these different styles that you can use to see your shape. My favorite is the shaded with edges. I think it makes it easy to see still the shades, and then it just adds a thin line along each of my edges of my cube. All right, then you can go back to 3D model. Now, if I wanted to create a hole through my cube, what I would need to do is click on the Modify button, check Hole. Okay, I'm going to want to create a hole that, let's say, is 1 inch long and 0.5 inches in diameter, so about half the size of my cube. And then it's going to ask for a center point. Okay. You just got to click on whichever plate that you want your hole to be at. Once you have your hole set, you can go ahead and click OK. Then we have our center hole in our cube. Another thing that we can do is we can create new sketches on top of our existing 3D parts. So what I would want to do here is just click again on create a 2D sketch, and it will ask you which part of the cube you want to create your new sketch on, which plane. So let's say I wanted to add a square piece on another side of my cube. I could just click on this side, make sure it's highlighted, and I'm gonna add a rectangle to the side of my cube. Again, you'll notice the yellow point with my XY coordinates. To make a square, it doesn't matter where you want to put it right now. I can make it centered later. So right now I'm just going to make a half an inch by half an inch square by going through my dimensions. Again, I'm entering 0.5 and then clicking tab, then entering 0.5 again and pressing enter. My sketch is green, that means I'm in progress of the sketch, it's not constrained at all. I'm going to go ahead and click escape, so I'm out of the draw function. And now I can constrain my inside square to be centered of my 1-inch square. Okay, so up here under constrain you will notice the word dimension. Go ahead and click on that. This will create dimensions for our drawing. You can do it just for sides of your part so you know that it's 1 inch by 1 inch. If you do so, sometimes it might give you this pop-up box here that says adding this dimension will over-constrain the sketch. That just means that it's already saying yes, the program knows it's 1 inch, you don't need to put that. You can accept that. Okay. Another thing that dimensioning is useful for is creating different lengths from two different sides. So I want to dimension this side, I click on it once it's highlighted in white, to this side of my inside square. So I click on that once and it will give me the length between the two boxes. Because I have a 0.5 inch square on the inside of a 1 inch square and I want it centered, I should try to have each of my sides be 0.25 or a quarter in length. So I'm going to click on my dimension here and it's going to do something pretty neat, which it lets you edit the dimension. So like I said, I wanted it a quarter or 0.25. So I go ahead, put that in, and then I click enter, and it automatically moved my inside square down, so now the sides are 0.25 inches apart. I can go ahead and do that with the other side right here. Enter in 0.25 and now my inside square is centered. You'll also notice that this square is now in dark blue versus the green. That means it is constrained. And I can go ahead and click finish sketch. Now if I wanted to extrude this, I would go ahead, highlight that side, right click, go to extrude in the upper right corner here of my shortcut menu, and it'll give me two options. Do I want to extrude the outside of that square or the inside? And I want to extrude the inside. So what I'm going to do is make sure that my mouse is on the inside and it's highlighted the small square. It's going to extrude it still that 1 inch that you had set before. I'm going to set it to 0.25. So now it is extruded 0.25 inches out. Then I'm going to click OK. And you can see here we have my cube. If I want to orbit my cube, I need to hold down the shift button on your keyboard and then hold down the scroll center button of your mouse. And then it will allow you to orbit your shape, your part. So I can move it around, check that my hole went all the way through, and then also that new square on the side is all set and ready to go. All right, so this concludes the little short introduction to Inventor. Let me know if you guys have any questions.